Hello friends, welcome to my channel ELS, English Literature Studies with Gaur Harpreet. My today's topic is The Rape of the Lock by Alexander Pope, in which I will discuss The Rape of the Lock as a social style or Alexander Pope as a representative of the 18th century. And my answer will also cover this question, how Alexander Pope reveals the manner of his age through his work, The Rape of the Lock. So let us start with the answer. The age in which Pope flourished is called Classical Age. The characteristics of Pope's age are more faithfully recollected in his poetry than histories and chronicles. He reflects facile optimism of his generation in much the same way as Tennyson mirrors in his work the problems of his age in the Victorian age. In his time, society was recovering from the years of the Puritan rule to the Restoration period. The civilizing influence of France resulted in a veneer of politeness and etiquettes which overlay brutality. He is almost unique in giving a complete reflection of the manners, literary tastes, and vices of his age. In The Rape of the Lock, the poet has dealt up with ladies of his time to show how other people saw them. Pope secretly laughs at his innumerable follies, and I will discuss these innumerable follies later on. So, he secretly laughs at his innumerable follies they said or did in the giddy pursuit of butterfly life. Their follies are fully exposed. Pope has given us a number of beautiful, highly colored pictures of the life of the fashionable ladies of London of 18th century. He has specially mentioned and selected the following as objects of our laughter and so much of moral condemnation. And these are innumerable follies. Number one, the habit of fashionable ladies to get up very late from their beds, their habit of spending hours before the dressing table, and this habit, Pope ridicules the woman's excessive concern with self-embellishment. These ladies are very fond for lap dogs, and they have desire for admiration from young men who had access to the court and about whom they dreamt in their sleep. Their craze for courtly balls and midnight barroom dances, where they were in danger of falling victim to the allurements of a treacherous friend. These ladies pretended to be sick only to show off their new dresses. Their foolish heads are filled with vision of peers, lords, and dukes, whom alone they consider to be eligible for their hands. Their practice of art of flirtation, even from their early years, then they pretend to blush at the thought of a fashionable young man, which causes their hearts to flutter. It is only the supernatural powers, the sylphs, that guide their way, and their ladies are very busy in their world of pleasure. They are saved by supernatural powers from yielding to some importunate lover, whose image is expelled from their heads by another who can boast of better sword knots. And these supernatural powers, having power to acquire any shape they fly, anywhere they like, they are always in attendance on the young ladies. In this way, poet makes us laugh at the fickleness of fashionable ladies, whose heart is compared to a toy shop. They elaborate costly cosmetics to look more beautiful and attractive. Their furious rage and grief on trifling occasions, like cutting off Belinda's lock of hair, their love and craze for new fashions, their improper habit of seeing male visitors, their susceptibility to hysteria, their pretension of illness only to show off their new dress, their habit of quarreling over trifles, all these are presented in varied colors. Lowell has very aptly remarked, "As truly as Shakespeare is the poet of man, as God made him, filling with great passion and motives, so truly is Pope the poet of society, the delineator of manner." The Rape of the Lock is the epitome of facile optimism and brilliance of the 18th century. The artificial tone of the age, the glorious aspects of femininity are nowhere more pictured than here in The Rape of the Lock. It is a page torn from pleasure-seeking life of fashionable life of London in the 18th century. It is the window through which we can have a peep into the 18th century of London. So friends, this is all about my today's video, and I hope you will like my videos. And if you like it, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe my channel. And if you are new on my channel, please hit the bell button so that you can get notifications for my upcoming videos. Thanks a lot for watching.